We are a bunch of superheroes keeping your food safe.
Chemists, biologists, toxicologists, entomologists, epidemiologists, nutritionists, data scientists. But what makes a good scientist? Student and FDA employee? Asking questions and searching for answers. We've brought you scientists offering thought-provoking glimpses into their work to protect the U.S. food supply. The goal is to inspire you to ask your own questions and let you see the possibilities of how science, technology, engineering, and mathematics can help you answer them.
Viruses are everywhere and are harmless until they find the right host to reproduce and thrive. Norovirus causes acute gastrointestinal distress. My research is focused on optimizing norovirus infection in human mini-guts, with the ultimate goal being able to proactively sample food products to determine if infectious norovirus is present, potentially preventing outbreaks. Norovirus foodborne outbreaks are often associated with foods that are consumed raw, like berries, lettuces, and oysters. To reduce outbreaks, wash your hands! Wash your hands! Wash your hands!
I get asked as a scientist at the FDA, is this safe? Is that safe? I read this. I saw this. I tell them, the ingredients I look at are in the food I eat and the food I serve to my family. I know they're safe. I know the caliber of scientists who are doing the reviews. And when we sit down, I know the food is safe. We perform review on color additives and regulate their use in the food supply. Every color must meet mandatory safety requirements. And what we do here in the Office of Food Additive Safety is important. The work we do impacts every person every day.
Every material that comes into contact with your food, whether through processing or packaging, has been evaluated by the FDA. Even recycled materials. We use science to ensure contaminants from recycled materials don't end up in the food supply. I'm Sean Fisher, Regulatory Review Scientist. My job is to ensure the safety of food packaging. I help influence the U.S. on the best ways to reduce plastic pollution across the globe.
Color additives must be pre-approved by the FDA for use in foods, drugs, cosmetics, and medical devices, and must be safe for their intended use. FDA develops and evaluates methods to identify and quantify potentially harmful ingredients and contaminants. We take dyes and pigments and separate sample mixtures using chromatography to see individual components, helping us identify the molecules in complex mixtures, such as tattoo inks, to better understand their composition, because 32% of Americans have a tattoo. Currently, no color additives are approved for cosmetics, skin injections.
With my chemistry background, I never thought that my job could involve me collecting samples on fishing expeditions in the Gulf of Mexico or Caribbean island. And it's my role to help develop methods to detect the toxin that causes ciguatera fish poisoning. This toxin is produced by microalgae in the reef and builds up in large reef fish, which are caught and served to people. Ciguatera fish poisoning is rarely fatal, with symptoms similar to food poisoning. At the FDA, we analyze seafood samples to determine areas which are unsafe for catching and eating fish.
I hate to break to you, but you are already eating bugs. Not nearly enough for you to recognize or cause harm, but down the hatch they go. Es natural. My work ensures domestic and imported foods that may contain insects don't end up in the hands of consumers. The majority of insects are beneficial, not harmful pests. Native bees and butterflies support pollination, fertilizing flowers, and helping plants to bear fruits. I work on new cutting-edge molecular techniques to detect and identify insects in a variety of food products. This method uses metagenomic next-generation sequencing technologies using short insect DNA.
Parasitic protozoan outbreaks are one of the leading causes of 1.7 billion cases of diarrhea every year. Those outbreaks are usually associated with consumption of fresh raw foods as leafy greens and berries. I create methods to find the parasite in food and water. To find Cyclospora, we use a filtration method, allowing us to find the parasites in water.
Coming onto the market, farm-free chicken. I'm Katie Overby, an FDA regulatory review scientist. Cultured animal cell meat presents a new way to consume protein. I get to see new food technologies that can make your food healthier, safer, and tastier with cutting-edge food science. Many ingredients you eat, someone at the FDA has reviewed it.
Eating fish tacos or sushi, it can contain a food poisoning molecule. And no matter how it's cooked or how it was stored, those molecules would still be present. I am Mayara Matos, a biologist in the Office of Food Safety. When seafood arrives to the US, it undergoes sensory analysis. FDA is developing methods to detect spikes of food poisoning molecules beyond relying on smell or looks.
Scientists work together to identify and track diseases. 10 years ago, before the advent of whole genome sequencing, it was much more difficult to do so. FDA works with scientists, analysts, surveillance teams, computer programmers, database trackers, along with several other different roles, working together as a team to document, categorize, and analyze the genetic data of diseases. We monitored sewage through the COVID pandemic and were able to recognize variants of the outbreak without conducting tests on every single person. We identified new variants with near real-time live tracking of COVID wastewater and shared the data directly to the public. This allowed scientists to see emerging variants across the nation.
More than 90% of the corn, soy, cotton, sugar beets, and canola grown in the U.S. are produced using biotechnology. And more than half the cropland harvested in the U.S. is planted with genetically engineered varieties. This forward-thinking science helps address the agricultural and climate challenges our food supply faces. It's estimated that by 2050, there will be 9 billion people on Earth. My work enables innovation needed to feed our growing global population. Identify what inspires you and follow it. With today's digital resources, it's much easier to learn about new technologies. Check out FDA's Feed Your Mind initiative to learn much more.